Ladies and gentlemen, signals the entry of the cadets onto the parade ground. And there they come out through the gates of the quartermaster's court, marching smartly to the inspiring refrain of the academy song, Hum NDA Ke Cadet Hain. Ladies and gentlemen, you can see the contingents marching onto the parade ground to take their positions. Led by November Squadron, which will be on the extreme left of the parade, as it was the champion squadron last year. Ladies and gentlemen, the magnificent grey horse, atop which the adjutant is astride, is Warrior. This splendid and dynamic charger was born in 1995 in Babugarh and was allotted to the National Defence Academy by Remount and Veterinary Corps in 1999. Warrior has been the adjutant's charger in the parade ground since 2001. Is Academy Cadet Captain J.S. Suman, who's commanding today's parade. Nourished.
सामने से गुजरे तब कृपया खड़े होकर तथा जो वर्दी में हैं वे सैल्यूट कर निशान को समुचित सम्मान प्रदान करें।
Gentlemen, the parade is now lined up for review. The cadet commanding today's parade is Academy Cadet Captain J.S. Suman. The officer on horseback to your extreme left is Lieutenant Colonel Gagandeep Singh, the Adjutant, National Defense Academy. An alumnus of this academy, Lieutenant Colonel Gagandeep passed out from Charlie Squadron 93rd Corps. A second generation Guards officer, he was commissioned into the 11th Battalion of the Brigade of the Guards in December 1998. The officer has varied operational experience, which includes active service on the IT Heights along the Chinese line of actual control and counter-terrorist operations in the Northeast. He has held the prestigious appointment of Weapons Instructor at the Infantry School Mau from 2004 to 2006. Wherein he was awarded the best instructor. As an infantry officer, he has the distinction of standing first in the prestigious battalion support weapons course at Infantry School Mau. He is also a graduate of the Defence Services Staff College. He was posted as a military observer in a highly active sector in the United Nations mission in Congo prior to his present appointment. The officer was awarded General Officer Commanding in Chief Commendation Card in 2012. As regards the lineup of the squadrons on parade, the pride of place to lead the parade is always reserved for last term's champion squadron. In this term, it is November squadron standing right next to the adjutant.
The next officer to be received by the parade is Air Marshal Kulwant Singh Gill, Ati Vishesh Seva Medal, Youth Seva Medal, Vayu Sena Medal Gallantry, Commandant, National Defence Academy.
Most of them have had their baptism with fire in the wars since independence. Some where blizzards and snowstorms shoot. Some where the wind blows full of sand. Some where the waves hold arguments with the sky. And some in the uncharted space above. But like professional soldiers, they were conscious of the hazards of the profession they had chosen. And were conscious of the contribution they were making to safeguard the sovereignty of our nation. In this long march to glory, our alumni have demonstrated exemplary courage and dedication, both in war and peace. They have defended our borders, kept the territorial waters safe for the nation and touched its sky with glory. A list of our alumni who have distinguished themselves in war would read like a veritable who's who of ancient heroes.
I know what you're right about.
There are some whom we always remember with special fondness. Captain Gurbachan Singh Salaria, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetripal, and Captain Manoj Kumar Pandey, all of whom showed extraordinary valor, daring, and determination of the highest order. Captain Salaria in Congo in 1961, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetripal at Chakragarh in 1971, and Captain Manoj Kumar Pandey at Thalwar in 1999. All three were posthumously awarded India's highest gallantry award, the Param Veer Chakra. Their spirit and that of others who made the supreme sacrifice resides in the hut of remembrance behind the Sudan block, which was built brick by brick, stone by stone, with the dedicated toil of the cadets of the 10th to the 17th Gossips.
Thank you.
Academic, specialist service training, outdoor training, exports form an integral part of a cadet's routine in the academy as they inculcate a sense of discipline and commitment in the budding soldier.
Thank you.
one gold, 3 silver and 2 bronze medals. In JNEC Bangalore, 4 gold, 1 silver and 2 bronze medals were bagged by our cadets. The Academy shooting team won 1 silver, 1 bronze medal at the National Shooting Championship held in New Delhi in December 2012.
Ladies and gentlemen, in short while, two Super Kona aircraft fly past over the quartermaster's post towards the Manoj Pandey block, flying directly over the quarter. They'll be flying in line astern formation and will then execute the peel off over the parade ground. Gentlemen, as you look to the extreme left of the parade, you can see Division Cadet Captain Ravindra Yadav from November Squadron coming to hand over the Chiefs of Staff banner to the Academy so that it can now be presented to the squadron that has won the championship this term. It is on the basis of the squadron's collective performance during the course of the term in four key activities, namely academics, outdoor training, specialist service training and games, that the championship is decided. Earlier we had the Commandant's banner for the champion squadron. The Chiefs of Staff banner was instituted during autumn term 1980. Bravo Squadron was the first to win it then. Thank you. The reviewing officer will present medals to the award winners in a short while. Winners of awards of Spring Term 2013 are Winner of the President's Gold Medal, Academy Cadet Captain J.S. Suman. Winner of the Silver Medal, Squadron Cadet Captain Vikrant Kumar. Winner of the Bronze Medal, Academy Cadet Adjutant Vishal Daya. Winner of the Chiefs of Staff Banner, November Squadron. The President's Gold Medal is awarded every term to the cadet standing first in the overall order of merit of the passing out course. In determining the award, regard is paid to the cadet's academic achievement, performance in outdoor activities, and to his officer-like qualities throughout his stay in the academy. The silver and bronze medals are awarded to the cadets standing second and third in the overall order of merit of the passing out course. The Chiefs of Staff banner is awarded to the squadron standing first in the overall championship. The championship is decided on the basis of points gained by the squadron in the various inter-squadron competitions held during the term. Squadron Cadet Captain Rishabh Raj of November Squadron will receive the Chiefs of Staff banner. Four young men is evident as they march forward to receive their well-deserved award. The reviewing officer is now requested to present medals to the award winners and the Chiefs of Staff banner to the champion squadron of this term. Winner of the President's Gold Medal, Academy Cadet Captain J.S. Suman. Winner of the Silver Medal, Squadron Cadet Captain Vikrant Kumar. Winner of the Bronze Medal, Academy Cadet Adjutant Vishal Dahiya. Winner of the Chiefs of Staff banner, November Squadron.
Bye-bye.
इन कैडेटों ने न सिर्फ अपने स्क्वाडन का नाम गौरवान्वित किया है बल्कि अपने माता पिता का शीश भी ऊंचा कर दिया है। नवंबर स्क्वाडन के कैडेटों के लिए भी यह अत्यंत हर्ष और उल्लास का समय है। इन्होंने पढ़ाई, शारीरिक प्रशिक्षण, खेल कूद व कवायद जैसी गतिविधियों में अपनी महारत साबित कर चीफ सब स्टाफ के प्रतिष्ठित ध्वज को प्राप्त किया है। चैंपियन स्क्वाडन होने के कारण नवंबर स्क्वाडन के कैडेट अब दाहिने कंधे पर स्लंतक लगाने के साथ साथ अपने स्क्वाडन भवन के आगे दो समारोहिक तोपे भी रख सकते हैं। साथ ही वे अपने स्क्वाडन भवन पर चीफ सब स्टाफ के प्रतिष्ठित ध्वज को फहरा भी सकते हैं।
The medal winners are marching back to take their position. It's indeed a proud moment for them as well as for all those who have been associated with their training here and of course for their parents. The cadets of November Squadron, it is also a special occasion as they have been declared the champion squadron and have received the prestigious Chiefs of Staff banner. The distinction of being the champion squadron entitles the squadron to put up the banner atop the squadron building next term. It also entitles the squadron to display two ceremonial guns at the entrance to the squadron, symbolizing their achievement.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a short while, two super demonas will fly past over the quarterdeck.
Hello.